Thank you for watching, liking, commenting, sharing, and subscribing right now.
Chris Perillo here covering CES 2013 for AMD. Follow the hashtag AMDSurround to find out what we're doing year-round. You guys told me to stop by the Ubuntu booth, so I'm here with Mark Murphy, and he's going to give us a demonstration of the Ubuntu phone.
Hi, so this is the Ubuntu phone. Basically, this is the welcome screen on Ubuntu phone. You can see here I've got messages that tell me, in this case, I've got 14 tweets in there. So the idea behind this is a very design user-focused design. It'll give me very clear visual indications, not just of the number, but by this sort of cloud around here, I get a good feel for it.
Oh, so that's not just a static wallpaper.
This is dynamic.
That's data. Wow.
So the whole idea is to basically create very visual experience on the phone itself. Also very touch focused as well. Obviously it's a telephone, people expect that. Our focus has been on using the edges. So for example here, I can actually just get access to this very easily by swiping here. So I'll swipe across, this will take me to the home page here. Here you see that I've got the most commonly used apps on the phone. I can modify that and customize that. Information, in this case it was a missed call from someone, and then access to services. And then this is a developer version, so we preload it with film services and music services, basically. And then I can swipe across to other environments where, for example, I've got my applications loaded here. They're the frequent ones that you've seen. Here I've got the installed applications on this phone itself, and then so I'll scan across. Further up, I've got applications that we'd recommend for download, and that could either be personalized to you or sort of hot hits for the day, and so on. And then services such as videos, and then across here, my people area here. So here I've got aggregation of various media or message content that's come in, so whether it's telephone, Skype, Facebook, tweets, whatever, I can connect to these things. So in this case, I'll just click on Florian. And you can see that he's been connected to me through Facebook. I can't show this because the internet's unfortunately down at the moment, but basically if I click on this, I can respond, interact with Facebook. At any point, I can just use this edge here to pull up the launch bar and go back to my home page, or scan across like this. And again, I can go to any of the applications I want here. So in this case, I'll click onto gallery. So we've got an example here of a photo application. And click on that. Pull up that, and I can edit it just as you'd expect to, throw it away, and so on and so forth. So that's that side of it. Also at the top you've got the usual indicators that you'd expect. We do push them away when you don't need them, so in some situations you'll see this disappear, and then obviously help and navigation tools will reappear. The great thing about these is I don't have to go to a utility or a setup application to actually modify or look at anything. I can swipe down here. So I can scan across, look at the day and date, go up here, look at the battery status, and then here we've got a message indicator here, and I can go back and look at all of those messages and the common use messages that we've seen before. That's pretty much a quick, short look at it. There's a lot on there.
So you can also connect this to the desktop?
Sure.
At some point, or
sure.
Now?
Sure.
Now?
I physically can't connect this one to the desktop, unfortunately. There's a common core. There's a common core of Ubuntu underlying this. So basically, there will be a full interaction between the desktop and the whole environment. So.
It's quite a value add, I would say, being able to use this as a full computer. That's what it is.